In these next two problems, we're going to graph compound inequalities. So these are a little bit different than what we were just dealing with, but still very similar. We're still going to be dealing with some shading here. So for this first one, y is between negative 5 and 1. So let's think about the two equations, y equals 1 and y equals negative 5. Those are both horizontal lines. One of them, and we're going to use a dashed line because of my inequality, one of them will be going through positive 1, and it's horizontal. The other one through negative 5, and it's also horizontal. It says y is greater than negative 5, and it's less than 1. So greater than negative 5 is on this side. Less than positive 1 is on this side. So I'm basically just shading right between the lines. And that's all there is to that one. You might be able to handle the next one on your own. Feel free to pause it. Here I have vertical lines. X equals 4 and x equals negative 3 are two vertical lines. Well, keep in mind these are going to be dashed because it's just strictly less than without the equal to. So I'm going to have a vertical line through 4 because that's what x equals 4 would look like as my equation of line, but it's x is less than 4, so use a dashed line. And then for negative 3, it would look like this because my equation of a line, when it's just an x equals negative 3 or x equals a number, is a vertical line, and this one's through negative 3. Keeping in mind, since it's strictly x is strictly greater than, it's a dashed line. X is strictly less than 4, it's a dashed line once again as well. Unless there's the equal to, it's a dashed line. Here I'm greater than negative 3, so I'm going to be on this side of the line. And for the 4, I'm less than 4, so I'm going to be on this side of the line, so I'm just shading in between the two vertical dashed lines.